The heart generates its own electrical impulse for the muscles to contract. Pacemaker cells initiate that electrical impulse. This video is not about pacemaker cells. This video will focus on the voltage passing through contractile myocardial cells. The red rounded corn square will represent the cardiac cell. Within that cell, you can see a small amount of sodium, represented by a salt shaker, a small amount of calcium, represented as a bone, and a large amount of potassium, represented as a banana. The amounts of each electrolyte is indicated by how full each item is. The potassium is 90% full, and the sodium and calcium are only about 10% full. Outside the cell are the same three electrolytes, potassium, calcium, and sodium. Outside the cell, potassium is only about 10% full, and sodium and calcium are about 90% full. All these electrolytes have a positive charge, so having more positive charges outside the cell makes the inside of the cell negative. Okay, what? Let's just pretend that we could count the number of items in each electrolyte. 90 grains in the salt, 90 in the calcium, and 10 in the banana. A total of 190. Inside the cell, 10 salt, 10 calcium, and 90 potassium. A total of 110. Inside a cell is a positive charge of 110 versus outside the cell with a positive charge of 190. 190 is greater than 110, so this means there is less positive ions in the cell. Let's look at these ions moving. Sodium moves slowly into the cell and then rapidly, causing potassium to exit the cell. The exit of potassium makes calcium rush into the cell, and all electrolytes have changed places. Now the inside of the cell is more positive than the outside. This switching of electrolytes is what causes the voltage change across that cell membrane. Let's graphically show this voltage change. Here I have a horizontal line representing time and a vertical line measuring millivolts. I will need to pause and highlight the animation as several events take place. Slowly moving sodium is coming into the cell. When the millivolts reach about negative 70, the sodium rushes into the cell, changing the inside of the cell to a positive 20. That rushing in of sodium stimulates potassium to exit the cell. As potassium exits the cell, causes a decrease in positive ions inside the cell. Now calcium starts entering. The exchange between potassium leaving and the calcium entering is equal, so no voltage change is happening. This is called a plateau. Now the cell does not like this, so it starts pumping sodium out and potassium in. At the same time, calcium is reabsorbed out of the cell. These events happen with every heartbeat, and a normal heart rate is about 80 beats per minute. The cell is now back to its baseline and ready to start again. I will play this animation again without narration or pauses. I hope this has helped, and thank you for watching.